Gender awareness plays an important role in making women and men aware about gender equality, benefits of gender equality, and the consequences of gender inequality. When we are gender aware, our attitude, behavior, and belief change positively against the inequalities between women and men and thus contribute to a balanced growth of the society. This is Ambepur, a small village in Raigad district of Maharashtra. We are here to meet Mia, Jay, and their family. Let's take a few minutes to see what's happening in their lives. Gender and related concepts. Mia has been selected to represent the school at the science exhibition in the nearby town, and she is running back home to share this news with the family, and she meets Dadi on the way back home.
Mama, I got selected to go to town for the science exhibition.
Dadi is very upset when she hears this.
Town? Are you crazy? Do you know how unsafe it is for girls? I listen about the scary situation on the radio every day. Do you remember your sister was also excited to go to town for agriculture extension training? Thank God that your father strictly told her that he would not entertain such a stupid ideas. See, now she is happily married. Forget it, all this silly science fair and town. Learn some household work like your mother and sister.
Even in today's age, women and even girls like Mia are denied the right to proper education. Men, on the other hand, have preferential treatment. Let us see what is happening in Jay's house. It's time for Jay to come back from school and Parvati is preparing kheer. Jay smells this and jumps into action.
Mama, are you making my favorite kheer? Please let me help you make the kheer, Ma.
Have you gone mad? You're a man and your job is not in the kitchen. Go out and watch TV or do your homework.
Most societies have treated men and women differently, giving men the advantage over women. Let us see how. On a bright day, Mia and Jay are walking back from school. They are passing by Ramu Kaka's shop. Just then, they see a couple walk into the shop to buy toys for their children. Kaka looks at the year-old girl and says,
"Take this doll and kitchen set. I'm sure you will love this. And you, beta, what would you like to have?" "I have guns, motorbike, cars, Spider-Man and blocks."
How come Chintu got a choice to pick what he wants, but Ramu Kaka decided that Guddi wants a doll and kitchen set?
Do you find these scenes familiar? Our society does not treat girls and boys equally. But wait, are girls and boys really equal? Definitely not in the minds of people like Dadi, Parvati and Ramu Kaka. Traditionally, girls have always been associated with jobs related to beauty, cooking, cleaning and so on, while men are associated with jobs involving tools, cars, bikes and so on. The reality is that most of these can be done by both girls and boys and men and women. Men and women are different biologically, but they are not unequal. But nature does not say that the male is superior to the female. Nature does not create hierarchies or superiority, but gender does. But what is gender? Come, let us learn. Gender is a socio-cultural definition of girls and boys, men and women, and is created by the society. Norms of society define what girls should wear, what they should do, how they should be treated, and their rights and responsibilities. Because societies create gender, the definition can vary from society and time to time. So, what is the difference between gender and sex? Sex is what you are born with and is the same anywhere in the world, whereas gender is what you learn socially. Based on our biases, we tend to associate certain articles or activities or roles with men and women. Now that we know the difference between sex and gender, let us see how we can differentiate the natural, that is sex, and the socially made, that is gender, activities. Children are taught gender from a very young age, sometimes as soon as we are born, that men and women are not equal. It continues forever through family upbringing, school education, advertisements, media, and so on. This is called socialization, teaching us how to behave, how to think and act in ways associated with one's sex. Socialization is done through different ways. Let's see how. Jay is just coming back from school. Parvati sees him limping and sulking.
Arey Jay, what happened? Why are you sulking?
You're a boy. You are supposed to be strong and not cry like girls. If you keep crying, how will you take care of your didi? Now stop playing with girls, else you will start behaving like them.
While Parvati and Jay are talking, they hear Mia singing.
Mia, why are you running and shouting like a boy? And what kind of dress are you wearing?
The girl child and the boy child are handled differently from a very young age. Codes of conduct are imposed on girls and women, such as do not run, dress like a girl, don't talk loudly, and so on. Similarly, boys and men are termed as girls and women when they show their emotions or cry. Dadaji and Mia are walking towards their home. Let's hear their conversation.
Dadaji, my teacher wanted us to write an essay on what we want to be when we grow up. Will you help me write an essay? I want to be an engineer.
Engineer? Why? It is such a difficult job. Engineers work with men and machines and carry loads. Girls are meant to do easy work.
Dadaji, but this is not easy work. Masi walks so far with water every day. And look at Gangubai. She gets firewood from so far so that she can cook.
The attention of girls and boys are directed in different directions and to different objects. This process begins very early in a child's life and is facilitated by parents and close family members. This process begins much before the child realizes the most basic biological differences between a male and a female. Let's see how society does that. That night, Radha and her husband are talking during dinner.
Today in our group meeting, it was announced that there is a training program on digital and financial literacy for farmers starting next week. I would like to join the program.
Why do you want to strain your tender hands by typing and all that? You are good at what you are doing, working in the field and taking care of your family. If you have time, just enjoy watching TV at leisure. You don't have to strain yourself anymore. Moreover, going there in the sun will make you go dark.
Don't do all this sweet talking. For 10 years I have been working in the field, doing all the work right from sowing to weeding and harvesting. Now I really want to go for the training so that at least this year I can come along with you to the mandi and know what happens out there.
Stop talking about it now. The mandi is not the right place for women to come. Go ahead and do whatever you want to do on the farm, but not beyond. I have now made my decision clear. Let us not create confusion in the mind of the child.
What did we see here? Girls and boys are exposed to different types of activities. Aren't we used to seeing father and son watching cricket while mother and daughter go shopping? In villages, girls are expected to help the mothers in the kitchen and look after younger siblings, and boys are expected to accompany the fathers to the fields or to the shops. Hey, look here. Looks like today is a special day. It is Dadiji's birthday. Mia and Jay are taking Dadi's blessings.
Mera Raja, beta. Study well and grow up strong. Rule the world and bring fame to the family.
grow up to be the most beautiful girl in the world, so that a charming prince comes and take you away.
Boys and girls are appreciated differently. While a boy may be appreciated for his strength, agility and marks at school, a girl may be appreciated for her looks, dress or cooking skills and craft. Gender bias not only creates differences in the society, but it also creates hierarchies and inequalities. Gender often determines opportunities and choices and can therefore cause discrimination. This is applicable to the farming system also. Gender inequality also impacts access to education, health or credit, etc. Gender equality is possible when men and women are treated fairly based on their needs. Power dynamics. Rules that apply to a male farmer are different from that of a female farmer. Let us see how power and privileges help individuals to progress ahead or go backwards. Let's take an example of the privileges that a male farmer has. A male farmer has access to ownership of farmland, can walk alone in the night, has the choice of using or not using a contraceptive, can go for training and meetings easily without any pressure of domestic work. He can even speak confidently about any concerns or problems in the village meeting or Gram Sabha and is not afraid of violence at home. He has the opportunity to watch TV or listen to the radio or read the newspaper. Now, a female farmer may not have the same privileges. These power and privileges help individuals to progress ahead or go backwards